Okay, today I'll be presenting on how I built my self-grounded Bowtie antenna from a commercially available tin. Before designing or constructing the antenna, we need to find the dimension of the antenna. So this is exactly the dimension of the antenna based on the frequency that I'll be using for the antenna. This antenna will be used on with a dual band modem router. After getting this dimension, we cut the tin to get this shape. These are the flaps. We fold them to get this shape. And after doing this, you can see that these two flaps are folded like this, and we need to feed them. Before feeding them, we need to feed the antenna using a coaxial cable. Before feeding them, we need to drill like two holes, the one underneath the antenna and two on the flaps. After drilling the holes, we feed the antenna and we solder the braids. As you can see, the braids are soldered on the flaps beneath the one on top. This is my final design. As you can see, there's a small gap between the two flaps, so for better performance of the antenna. After this, we'll go to the testing part. So, okay, this is the part where we'll be measuring the signal strength using the WIFI analyzer application. As you can see on the phone, the signal strength called antenna will be appearing on the application. As I move, you'll see that, you can see that the signal strength is changing while moving away from the antenna. This is how I measured the signal strength for my antenna. After testing the antenna, the constructed self-grounded Bowtie antenna radiation pattern shows that the antenna mainly radiates in one direction. This validates our expectation. Among some tricks that I learned from the project, the antenna testing performance depends on the testing method used in the project. The antenna gain and its performance actually depends on the way the antenna is oriented to the signal strength receiver, the free space losses and feeder losses. These losses affect the gain and the antenna performance.